What is going on, you guys? Nicolo Maserati here. So if you guys saw one of my recent videos, I did a video where I teach you guys how to do a speed ramp in After Effects. Well, today we're going to be taking what we learned in that video and we're going to be learning how to do a speed ramp transition in After Effects. So you do real estate videos, travel videos, or vlogs. Learning the speed ramp transition and using it in your videos will take your videos to the next level. Actually, not just the next level, it'll take you to the boss level. But before we get into it, let's run that intro. All right, guys, so like I said, today we're gonna be learning how to do a speed ramp transition in After Effects. But before we get into all that, if you enjoy this kind of content and you wanna see more, make sure you subscribe and hit that bell so you can be notified every single time I upload a new video. All right, let's just get into After Effects. All right, so we are in Adobe After Effects right now. And as you can see, I have two videos here. I have one of a lake time lapse, and then I have one of mountains and clouds. So the first thing that I'm gonna do is my lake time lapse clip is going from right to left, and my drone clip for the mountains is going from left to right. So when you're doing transitions like this, you want to make sure everything is going in the same direction. So all I'm going to do is I'm going to take my lake time lapse and I'm going to reverse it so that it's going from left to right instead of right to left. So what you want to do is right click that clip, go to time and enable time remapping. You're going to see we have these two keyframes here. This is our beginning keyframe and our end keyframe. And all you're going to do to reverse it is you're going to take this first keyframe, you're gonna drag that to the beginning of the video. You're then gonna take the end keyframe and drag that to the beginning. And just like that, we have reversed this clip and now it is going from left to right. So everything's super consistent. From here, I'm gonna move this clip over and I'm actually gonna hide it just by hitting this little eye icon. And we're just gonna focus on this clip. So what we wanna do is speed ramp the end of the clip. So the first thing we're gonna do is we're gonna right click the mountains clip and we're gonna go to time and enable time remapping. And again, we have our two keyframes that are created, the beginning keyframe for the beginning and the end keyframe for the end of the video. From here, we're gonna find a good place to start our speed ramp. So if I go through here, I kind of like that timing right there. The clip doesn't need to be too long. So I'm going to go over here, hit this little diamond. Now we've created a spot to start our speed ramp. From here, I'm gonna click and drag and take these two keyframes and drag these all the way to the end of the clip. So what we've done is we've created this spot where it's about 2 seconds. Then we've condensed that point originally between these last two keyframes and we've made them faster. So if we go here and we hit the space bar, you're gonna see what happens. And I think I wanna make them a little bit faster, so I'm gonna make sure those two keyframes are selected. I'm just gonna drag it just a tad bit closer to the end keyframe. We're gonna take our little playhead and we're gonna put that over this very first keyframe. We're then gonna click until we see arrows going in both directions and we're gonna drag until that very first keyframe. Then we're gonna take this, drag this all the way to the beginning, and now we have our first clip with the speed ramp at the end. So from here, we want to create a speed ramp at the very beginning of our lake time-lapse video. So for the same thing, we have the beginning and end keyframe. So we're gonna find a point, because the beginning is gonna be sped up, we wanna find that point where it's gonna start to slow down again. I kinda like that right about there. So I'm gonna stop there, I'm gonna hit that little diamond, and then I'm gonna take the last keyframe and then the keyframe that we just made, and I'm gonna drag that to the very beginning. And what that's gonna do is that's gonna speed up the beginning of the clip. Let's take a look at what we have so far. We've sped up the beginning and end. That looks really nice, but there's a couple more things that we can do to really take this clip to that boss level. So what you wanna do is highlight all three keyframes for your mountain clip. You're then going to go to your graph editor, and we're gonna be working in the value graph. So if for some reason you're seeing this right here, you just wanna click down here to the right of the eye, and you wanna make sure a value graph is selected. These two points here represent the speed ramp. What we wanna do is we wanna focus on the beginning keyframe for this one. So if I drag over here, you're gonna see that highlighted. You're then gonna go to the right here and you're gonna click Easy Ease Out. You're gonna see this little handle is created. You wanna just take that and drag it as far out as it can go. You also wanna make sure that this yellow handle is in line with this line here. So if it's off like this, or if it's too high like that, it's not gonna do much. So you wanna make sure it is in line with this white line. Now let's see how it looks. That looks really good. I like that. So we're going to get out of the speed graph and we're going to do the same thing with the lake time lapse clip. So we're going to make sure we click and drag and highlight all those keyframes. We're then going to go back to our graph editor. These two keyframes here is where our speed ramp is taking place. So you want to take the last keyframe. You want to go down here and instead of doing easy ease out, you want to do easy ease in. You're then again going to take that handle, drag it to where it's in line with this white line here. So if we click out of this and we take a look at everything, let me just make this a little bit smaller here. You're gonna see how everything looks. Yeah, that looks really good. I like that. Okay, there's one more thing that we're gonna do to, again, just keep taking it up a notch. Those little things, those little details make a big difference when it comes to making videos and stuff like this. So what you wanna do is right click and you wanna go to new and click adjustment layer. From here, we're gonna drag the adjustment layer to where the very first speed ramp keyframe starts. And then you wanna drag the end to where the very last keyframe of both clips ends. Now we've just created this little adjustment layer over our keyframes. From there, you're gonna wanna go to effects and presets and type in force motion blur. You're then gonna take that motion blur and you're gonna drag it right onto your adjustment layer. And that's it. So let's take a look at the finished product. There you have it, guys. That is how to do a speed ramp transition in After Effects. So I hope you enjoyed this video. I hope you got something from it. If you did, make sure you subscribe, hit like, and I'd love to hear what you think of this in the comments. All right, guys, I will see you in the next video.